Is it worth crossing the whole Atlantic Ocean to live in a country where you don't know anyone and no one speaks your first language? In today's video, we're going to talk about the engineering market for migrants in Australia, the challenge you might face if you're an immigrant in this country, and answer the question if it's worth moving to down under. According to the Australian Bureau of Statistics, 51% of engineers working in the profession in Australia are born overseas. 59% of qualified engineers in Australia are migrants. Yet overseas-born engineers have a higher unemployment and underemployed rate compared to locally-born engineers. And these figures are even worse for overseas-born female engineers, who have almost three times the unemployment rate of Australian-born female engineers. And in case you're asking yourself, what the biggest barrier to seeking work as a migrant engineer in Australia is, I'll tell you. According to a recent research conducted by Engineers Australia involving more than 800 migrant engineers, the biggest barriers are no Australian work experience, international experience not valued in Australia, no local professional network or local reference to use, and jobs are only available to Australian citizens and residents. Now you might be thinking,
that's terrible news. I'll never get a job. Thanks, Gabriel, for killing my dreams.
Wait. It's not what you're thinking. With the borders restrictions, there's an emerging engineering skills shortage in Australia. In addition to that, there's been an infrastructure boom. So let's first have a look at some more data, break down all this information and make a conclusion. If you have a look at this graph by Grattan Institute, the last bar you will see that in the middle of 2019, the value of projects under construction was over $120 billion. And 2/3 of these projects are mega projects, costing over $5 billion. Did you pay attention to what I just said? It's mega project. It's not only mega, it's a mega. When something is mega, it. Anyway, you got the point. Before 2010, we didn't even know what a project over $5 billion looked like. This other chart by ABS Labor Force shows that employment in heavy and civil engineering construction surged by 50% from 2016 to 2019. And as a stock trader myself, I can tell you the trend is up. Place your bets for the next 10 years. Also, you would think that the pandemic would slow down construction in Australia, but it was quite the opposite. From personal experience, I've been working on double of the amount of projects that I would have been working at this same time of the year prior pandemic. And the future is bright for you, my fellow engineer. Based on this last chart, no more charts after this one, I promise. We can tell that the number of infrastructure projects in New South Wales, Queensland, Victoria, and WA is massive for the upcoming years, especially because of the Olympic Games in Brisbane in 2032. Now let's go back to the issues immigrants encounter according to the research by Engineers Australia that we talked about in the beginning of this video. First, no local experience and international experience not valued in Australia. From my point of view, if the business needs your skill set, it doesn't matter where you acquired your experience, if it's overseas or whatever. As long as you can bring value to the company and they need your services, there are no reasons for them not to hire you. However, if you are applying for a more senior role, naturally it is expected some level of local experience, and therefore you might have to consider start from a supervised role so you can gain this local experience. The second barrier was no local professional network or local reference to use. Okay, allow me to give my two cents here. Networking is not calling everyone and asking them for a job. What I would do is to meet people, get to know them better, and see how they might be able to help you, and also how you can help them. Develop relationships, show honest interest in the other person, and eventually you will have a vast array of contacts that can help you with employment. And you can do that through LinkedIn and any professional events happening in your area. And the last barrier reported in the research was not having permanent residency or citizenship. The problem with that is In some types of visa, you're not allowed to work full time. Also, if you're not a permanent resident, the company risks investing time and resources on you, and eventually you might need to return to your own country. But as I said before, with this skills shortage, I believe if you are in a temporary visa that allows you to work full time, you won't have any issues. Even if you're on a student visa, you still have heaps of opportunities. Trust me, I've been there. However, I would strongly advise you to chase permanent residency as soon as possible. There are skilled visas, visa 189, 190, and many other pathways you can follow to achieve your citizenship. So in summary, if you think there is a skill shortage in Australia, you're probably right. And if you are an engineer looking for an opportunity, this is your time to shine, my friend. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you want to learn how to get your first engineering job, you can watch this video here, and I'll see you next time.